Yo, what's up, Clutcher Crew? Welcome back to my final prediction video for the MLB season. We covered the MVPs, we covered the Cy Youngs, and now I'm going to cover playoffs. I cannot wait. The season starts tomorrow. Let's get into this, shall we? And I want you all to know, I'm not trying to throw hate or shade towards any team. Well, maybe except one team. But I feel like sometimes you guys think I'm doing that. I'm not. This is just the predictions I think for the upcoming season, each and every year. Let's get right into it. Starting with my favorite team's division, the American League West, which has been ruled by the cheaters, I mean the Astros, the last couple seasons. And unfortunately, I think that's gonna happen again. I think the Astros got so lucky this year. Why, you may ask? Because there is no fans. No fans to heckle, get in their head, be right there in their ear. You are so lucky. But I still think it's gonna take a little bit of a toll on them this season, but not as much as it would have impacted them if there were fans. Oh my God, I cannot express how lucky they are. Besides that, they still got a talented staff, which I hate to admit. They got Justin Verlander and Zach Greinke leading their pitching rotation, both Cy Youngs, both proven aces, and their lineup is still stacked. I hate to say it. They got Bregman, they got Correa, Springer, Altuve. Who knows how good they will be since they've been caught, but I can't really say much until we've actually seen that. In my head, they are still the best in the West. Hate to say that. I just want to clean my tongue after I say that. But yes, Astros fans, I still think you have the most talent in the American League West. The Angels and the Athletics may be able to compete this year in the shortened season, but I don't think so. With the pitching they have, the offense that they have, it's a tough team to beat. But yeah, there you go. I think the Astros will win the American League West. I'm also just going to tell you who I think is going to win each division. I'm not going to go first, second, third, fourth, fifth, because this is a playoff prediction video, so I really just got to tell you who I think is going to win each division, then the playoffs, and then the World Series. Moving on to the American League Central, I think this division will be won by the Twins in their high-powered offense. They already had Miguel Sano, Nelson Cruz, Eddie Rosario, Max Kepler, and now they added Josh Donaldson, who proved he is still raking and dropping the rain at his age, and I think that's amazing. He's a former MVP, and he's returning to a form that looks very good. So you throw him into this lineup that is already stacked, it gets even scarier, and I think it's going to be one of the toughest offenses to stop in baseball. They did address their starting rotation as well. They added Rich Hill and Kenta Maeda, which should help them a little bit. They got Jose Berrios, but that offense is really going to be the factor. It's going to carry the team. It's going to carry them to a division title. I think they lock up the American League Central once again, and there you go. Minnesota, I think you're going to win that division. Now moving on to the American League East, staying on the subject of power and hitting bombs, I think this will be won by the Yankees. They got Aaron Judge, Giancarlo Stanton. Those two alone hit monster shots, moon shots. And even though they are prone to injury in a shortened season, I think that is less likely. But if it does happen, then it's going to be a huge hurt to them. But they've got talent on this team. They've got Gleyber Torres, Gio Urshela, Aaron Hicks, Gary Sanchez. This team hits home runs, and they do it well. Plus, they added the top free agent pitcher in Gerrit Cole to their rotation. So, ooh, nasty. They have one of the best bullpens in baseball, so I think this team is balanced all around. They got the offense, the pitching, and starting and bullpen. So you put that all together, you got a really, really good team, and that's why I think they're going to win the American League East. Now the National League, starting with the NL West, because it's the easiest one to predict. I think the Dodgers are going to win the NL West. Is anybody shocked? Does anybody else really compare to the Dodgers in the NL West? They are so stacked with talent, and then they added Mookie Betts. Are you kidding me? You already have last year's MVP, Cody Bellinger, who has proved that he can play in this game as a very talented all-star caliber player. And then you got Justin Turner, Corey Seager, top prospect Gavin Lux. It's unfair. This team has so much talent. And then you go to the mound and you got Kershaw, you got Bueller. It's crazy how much they have on this team. Their bench is also solid. So that is why I think the Dodgers are going to win the NL West. They just got too much. Too much for anybody else in that division to compete. Next, we are talking about the National League Central, which I think will be won by the Cardinals, just slightly beating the Reds. The Reds improved a lot this season, but I think the Cardinals are going to get this just because they have a slightly better pitching rotation. They got Jack Flaherty, who's proven to be a top arm in the league. Dakota Hudson and Miles Mikolas are also very solid, and their offense is good as well. You got Colton Wong, Tommy Edman, Harrison Bader just is amazing in the outfield, always dive and make it the catches. Paul Goldschmidt, Yadier Molina, one of the best defensive catchers. It's just a solid team all the way around, and I think they just slightly beat the Reds for the National League Central. And finally, the National League East. This was probably the hardest one for me to choose because I was stuck between the Nationals, Mets, and Braves. Tons of talent on all of those teams, but I think the reason I picked this team is because of their pitching, and that is the Nationals. They are led by Max Scherzer, Steven Strasburg, Patrick Corbin, and we saw last year, they have a never-die attitude. They're gonna fight no matter how down they may seem. They are gonna try their best to come back, and look what they did last year. It led them all the way to a World Series championship. They got the pitching, like I said. They got the offense led by young, talented Juan Soto. This guy has so much confidence, and I think all that together is going to help the Nationals win the National League East. I'm going to give you the wild card teams, which I think will be my Angels and the Tampa Bay Rays. First, let me talk about my team. We got two proven superstars in Mike Trout and Anthony Rendon, with other solid bats around them like Justin Upton, Shohei Ohtani, Tommy LaSella broke out last year and became an all-star, and David Fletcher is a solid, scrappy hitter who hits for average and gets the hits. He doesn't need to hit the home runs. And we slightly addressed our pitching in the offseason. Julio Teheran is going to play, but he might not start the season for a little longer because he did deal with coronavirus problems, got over it, so it's probably going to be a month before he comes into the season. And we also grabbed Dylan Bundy, who should eat a lot of innings for us, and I think we'll succeed a lot more outside of the American League East. But you got to deal with a lot of powerful and talented hitters. That's one of the best divisions in baseball. So coming to the AL West, I think he will do a little better. Griffin Canning is going to be able to do his job. And I'm forgetting somebody. Shohei is going to be able to pitch. And I think they just announced today that Sundays are going to be his starting days. So it's good to see that our pitching did improve just a tiny bit, but I think enough to help us not get destroyed every single time, and the offense is definitely there. Tampa Bay Rays, who are a young, solid team, they got Austin Meadows, Brandon Lowe, Willie Adames. They got talent that is going to sprout in the next few years. And they got Wander Franco, who is an up-and-coming prospect. The pitching is solid for the Rays. They got Blake Snell. They got Tyler Glasnow. They got Charlie Morton. Those guys are all aces. At the end of the day, I think the team that is going to win the wild card game is my Angels, baby. I think we can win that one game. I think it'll be very close. It's going to be tough, but I think we throw Shohei on the mound since it's a one-and-done kind of game. And then we have the offense to back him up with Rendon, Trout, LaSella, Fletcher, Upton. It's a talented team, and if Adele's there too, that helps also. So there you go. I think the Angels will move on to the next round. Now we're talking about the National League wild card, which I think will come down to the Reds and Braves. The Reds added so much in the offseason with Nick Castellanos, Mike Moustakas, putting them already with a team that had Aristides Aquino, who last year blew up, and I think has the talent to do it again this year. Joey Votto, a solid veteran. He's one of the funniest players in baseball, if you ask me. I'm sure people have different opinions, but I think he's hilarious. It's all jokes. Luis Castillo leading the rotation. He has proved that he is a top arm in the league as well. Now we're talking about the Braves, who have a young, talented superstar themselves in Ronald Acuna Jr., along with Ozzie Albies, who is a very good second baseman. But the punch to the gut for this team is the fact that they might not have Freddie Freeman. Another player that is not going to be there for the Braves is Nick Markakis. He opted out of the season, and they tried to replace him with Yasiel Puig, but then Yasiel Puig came down with COVID problems, and they did not sign him. The real question is, who do I think is going to win this wildcard game between the Reds and Braves? And I think it is going to be the Reds. They throw Luis Castillo on the mound in this one-game elimination, and I think they are looking good, especially with how talented their offense is now after adding all those pieces. I think it's going to be tough to beat them, especially with how many hits the Braves are taking. They're a talented team. Both of them are. But I think the Reds are going to have the advantage. Now that we're done with the wild card games, let's go back to the American League and talk about the ALDS, starting with the Astros versus Twins. this is going to be a very entertaining series. I think it will go 5 games. The Astros have proven they got the talent, but they did it in the wrong way. And the Twins got power. They're going to hit bombs, but I don't think that'll be enough. The only reason I am picking the Astros to beat the Twins is because I think they had the pitching to shut down this Twins lineup with Greinke and Verlander in a short series. It's going to be tough, and I think the Astros will beat the Twins 3-2. Next, we are talking about the Yankees versus my Angels. Both talented lineups. They both got offense. The Yankees are going to hit more bombs than us, definitely, but they also have the pitching and the bullpen, which is going to hurt us because we do not have pitching in the rotation or the bullpen, and that is going to be our weakness in the division series. As much as I want my Angels to move on, and as much as I believe, I'm going to say Angels World Series all day, every single year, but being realistic right here, the Yankees have too much power. Our pitching is not good enough, in my opinion, to shut them down yet, so I think the Yankees will win the ALDS versus my Angels 3-1. Now we're talking about the NLDS, starting with the Cardinals and Nationals. The Nationals, they're last year's World Series champions. They are led by Strasburg, Scherzer, and Corbin in the rotation, and the young stud Juan Soto in their lineup. The Cardinals are that team that kind of sneaks up on you. They got the pitching, it's solid. In the lineup, it does the job, but I don't think it's as good as the Nationals. Like I just said, the Nationals, they have a solid 3. In a short series, that's going to be tough to beat because they're going to throw all 3 at you, and they're all going to be pretty much dominant. So the Cardinals really do have to pull something out of their magic bag if they're going to get past them. And that's the whole reason why I think the Nationals are going to beat the Cardinals 3-1. I think they just got too much into the pitching department, and I think their lineup is better. So that is why I'm picking them to beat the Cardinals. Dodgers versus Reds. Do we even have to talk about this one? The Dodgers are so talented from 1-9 in their lineup, dude. It's unfair. Cody Bellinger and Mookie Betts on the same team? I cannot even believe that's a real thing. I've said it. The Reds have added their pieces, but they did not have the pieces that the Dodgers did. Even though it was just one superstar, it's the kind of superstar you want on your team. There's no way I think the Reds can beat the Dodgers. So I think the Dodgers will sweep them and it'll be 3-0. The ALCS, the Yankees versus the Astros. The Astros, like the Dodgers, have found themselves in the World Series 2 of the last 3 years, cheating their way to 1 and then losing last year to the Nationals. The Yankees have been in the playoffs for the last couple of years, and this year they got tons of talent. They've added an ace in Gerrit Cole, and I think the Yankees are going to be able to get past the Astros this year, mainly because I think they got the pitching to compete with them. Gerrit Cole, like I just said, has been added. And then you got J.A. Happ, who's pretty solid. You got Masahiro Tanaka, if he's able to pitch by this point. We all know he had that line drive to the head. I think he's going to be fine. He walked off the field under his own power, and I haven't heard much after that, but the rotation is looking good. I think the Yankees have found enough pitching for their rotation and their bullpen. Their lineup is very talented that I think they're going to be able to beat the Astros in this year's American League Championship Series. I think they will take it 4-2. NLCS, Dodgers versus Nationals. We all know what the Nationals did to the Dodgers last year in the NLDS. It shocked the world. They shocked everybody. And this year, I think that is not going to happen. The Dodgers, like I've said multiple times, they're just too good. Now that they've added Mookie Betts, I don't think there's any way they can choke this season. They normally do that when it comes to playoffs, but I think this year is just impossible. I just cannot picture a scenario where they are taken down by any other team in the National League. Even though the Nationals do have the pitching, I've mentioned their solid 3 multiple times with Scherzer, Strasburg, and Corbin, I think this lineup is way too good to be shut down by all 3 of those pitchers every single time. Such a good team, and I hate to admit it because I'm always butting heads with my Dodger Films crew. I'm like, Angels, baby! And they're all like Dodgers. And I'm like, why? Why do you have to be so good? But yes, I think they will beat the Nationals 4-2. That means my World Series would be Yankees versus Dodgers, a historic classic. Both of these teams mean so much to the history of baseball. The Yankees, they got their 27 rings. The Dodgers have been around, and they got their rings as well. These teams definitely have stacked lineups. Their pitching is solid for both of them. And I swear, I have predicted you guys in the past, and you choked it. You choked it. And this is the last time I am going to predict you to win the World Series. That's right. I think the Dodgers are going to win the World Series. But like I said, last time, if you guys choke it again, then I can't even. I just will not predict you because I just know you're going to ruin it in the end. That's what you've done in the past. Dodgers, I think, will win the World Series. 4-3. It's going to game seven. There you go. That is my playoff prediction with the Dodgers winning the World Series. I don't see how they could lose this one, especially in a shortened season. This is going to be a crazy season, guys. I hope you're ready. Buckle up. If you made it to the end of this video, then leave your World Series prediction down below. Like the video, subscribe, tell your mom, your dad, your grandma, your pets, your friends, everybody know I got this, and I will see you next time.